우리 학교 환경이 네. 네. 어떤 것 같아? 참 공부에도 도움되고 정서적이고.
아, 예, 지금 보시는 것과 같이 되게 자연 친화적이잖아요. 그래서 뭐 공부하는데 정서적으로 도움도 많이 되고, 그리고 서울보다 공기가 맑기 때문에 뭐 네 건강도 좋고 뭐 그런 것 같습니다. 도움이 많이 되는 것 같습니다.
여기 동물도 되게 많은 것 같던데.
예, 아, 그 오리도 있고 고양이도 있고 토끼도 있고 저는 날다람쥐도 봤는데요. 뭐 지나가는 사람들도 참 친절해가지고 뭐 먹이도 많이 주고 누군 때렸다고도 하는데 뭐 동물학대도 가끔 일하는 것 같아요.
이해가 있어.
아, 동물학대. 아, 굿.
굿. 뭐 개인적인 뭐 공부에 직접적으로 도움을 받은 적이 혹시?
아, 그 저번 학기 기말고사 때인데 그 제가 머리가 공부를 많이 하다 보니까 아프더라고요. 그래서 잠깐 밖에서 한 시간 동안 좀 쉬면서 있다 보니까 머리가 바로 맑아지던데. 그리고 뭐 시험도 뭐
야
잘 네, 봤어요.
그게. 어, 학점 잘 나온 거야?
네, A0 나왔어요.
오. 뭐 그런 식으로 괜찮은 것 같아요. 도움이 많이 되는 것 같아요.
그래서 네. 한마디로 우리 학교 환경이 참 100점 네. 만점에
예, 네, 공부하기 정말 적당한 곳이고 뭐 공부하기도 좋고 우리가 또 여기가 살잖아요. 기숙사 생활을 하다 보니까 환경이 되게 중요한데 주변 환경이 참 좋은 공기도 좋고 뭐 환경도 좋으니까 예, 네, 아주 적당한 장소인 것 같습니다.
예, 뭐 굿.
감사합니다.
굿.
Surely, students and locals can benefit from this. However, is Sky's plan really perfect without disadvantages? Now we will try to compare Sky's at different universities in Hong Kong to see the differences between their environment and their effects. And the first university to compare is the Hong Kong Polytechnic University. This university is well known of its design and special outlook. It is filled with red brick as we see in this picture. And this is the logo of the university. It is packed with letter U and letter P. This kind of close pack characteristic also appears in the university, as its size is much smaller than Kai's. How small? So is this small. Crowd with students and people. And what's serious is just near the school is a very famous course harbor tunnel which stuck with cars every day. This creates a poor air quality around the university and inside. Then we look into the university. We can see that all around us are buildings. This kind of building design makes air even much more difficult to go in. With air pollution and bad air ventilation, though there are trees around, the air quality is still bad. The health of students may be affected.
Here is the overview of the Poly University in Hong Kong. As you can see, Poly U is very much packed and very small in size. However, it is at the center of the downtown of Hong Kong, which gives great and easy access to the vibrant city.
Next is the comparison between Kai's and the Hong Kong University of Science and Technology, which is called HKUST. The size of the two schools is quite similar, but the difference is that HKUST is near the sea, so that nice wind will blow around the school.
The environment of HKUST is really nice because it is built along the slope with surrounding hills. The entire campus is surrounded by trees and plants, so I think the air there is really fresh. Besides, it is located along the seashore line, providing us a spectacular sea view. So when we are studying and feeling very tired, we can look outside the window and enjoy the sea view, and I will feel very relaxed afterwards.
Actually, I think the natural environment in HKUST is quite nice, because when you're studying in the library or in the hall, there is a great sea view for you, and there are a lot of trees around HKUST.
I think the campus design of HKUST has already incorporated the idea of green environment into it. For example, most of the buildings are linked by bridge instead of roads, which help minimizing the plantation, reserving a lot of green space for us. Besides, recycle bins are located everywhere in the campus, and our computer barns will collect the waste paper and set aside for students to use it as scratch paper. Apart from this, we have a lot of recycling competition. For example, there's a competition among students which is to collect as much plastic bottle to recycle as possible. The competition helps increasing the environmental awareness among us. So I think our school has done quite a lot to help promote green environment.
I think the school didn't actually put much effort in developing the natural environment in HKUST, because although there are a lot of trees, but their locations are very unplanned and dispersed, and they are not concentrated, and there are no names around it so that the student can actually understand what the kind of trees they are. And there are no any recreational facilities for students to walk around the trees and know more.
HKUST is also well known as Hong Kong University of Stress and Tension. However, the beautiful scenery of South China Sea and the surrounding green environment make my life easier to handle all kinds of stress arising from my homeworks, projects, quiz and exam. So rather than asking me whether I have time to enjoy the green environment here, I'd rather say it has already immersed into every part of my life.
Also, the structural plan is quite different. First, here shows the overview of HKUST. They try to put everything inside a huge academic building. The circle here indicates that the location of departments, classrooms, lecture rooms, library, restaurant, and so on. Also, the dormitory is connected to the main building by the bridge link, in a quite short distance. This gives a very much convenience to people in HKUST.
The environment of HKUST is very convenient to us. The buildings are linked together, and the buildings with similar functions will be grouped together. For example, the academic building is located right next to the main entrance. This is the place for all students to take lessons, and the residential area are linked to the academic building just by a bridge. So it's very convenient to the students to access to the academic building any time in the day. Besides, as I said before, our academic building is the only place we take lessons. So when we change from one classes to another classes, it only takes us about 15 minutes. So we can have enough time to grab our breakfast or lunch in between the lessons.